Hi guys. So it looked like you really enjoyed the ice fishing lab, and I can tell you that I really enjoyed watching all of your videos and looking at all of your pictures and reading all of the things that you wrote to me about yourselves and about what you thought that experiment was about. You had some really good ideas. I'm super impressed at your science knowledge and what it looks like you're ready to learn. So I want to talk a little bit about what happened in yesterday's experiment on the science end of things. So, scientifically speaking, this is what was really occurring. You had ice and you had water, and obviously that's very cold, right? And ice freezes at 32 degrees Fahrenheit. Well, when we add the salt to the ice water, what happens is that it causes the freezing temperature to change. So the temperature at which water, pure water, freezes is 32 degrees Fahrenheit. The temperature at which salt water, say as salty as the ocean water, will not freeze until that water gets down to 28 degrees or so. So it has to be a lot colder for salty water to freeze. So when we added the salt, what happened is that it caused that ice to melt. But because the ice was in cold water, the salt that we used wasn't very much salt. It caused the temperature to, or it caused the ice to melt, but then that cold water caused it to get cold very quickly again, and it refroze. But because it had melted and the string was in there, when it refroze, it froze right onto the string. So it wasn't exactly that the string got sticky or that the salt was sticky. It was really about the salt changing the melting and freezing temperatures of the water. So there's your science for today, or for yesterday. So you might notice that as part of today's assignment, I included Grace's video. And I included Grace's video because I was really impressed with the way that Grace was thinking like a scientist. She did the experiment the way that I asked her to do it, and it worked great. And then she had some questions that popped in her head. And she said, "I wonder what would happen if I did this." And she tried it. It didn't really work very well. You'll see that. But that's okay because now she knows. And actually, one of the things that she talked about doing was adding a lot of salt. Well, when she added a lot of salt, what happened is that she caused the ice to freeze, to melt very, very quickly. But because there was so much salt in the water, it couldn't get cold enough to be able to refreeze around the ice cubes around the string. So she didn't catch anything. But she learned from that. So that's what's really important. And then she did a couple of other things, tried some different things to see what would work and what wouldn't. And that was super impressive to me because that's what scientists do. So as you're going through these experiments, I want you to really try and do that. Try and think like a scientist. So if you're ready, let's get on to today's experiment. So you see this little cartoon here. What you're seeing is a poor little old explorer of some sort stuck in quicksand. I'm sure you've all seen cartoons or heard stories about people or animals or objects getting stuck in quicksand and having a hard time getting out. I actually had an experience like that one time when I was at sixth grade camp. I had some kids that were trying to catch some frogs at the edge of the pond, and they went deep and deeper, deeper into the pond, and they were up to their knees, and all of a sudden they were stuck. And we had to come over and try and pull really, really hard to get them out, and they just kept sinking. We ended up having to dig them out, and we had to leave their boots in the mud because their boots just would not come loose. So today, in your experiment, we are going to be making some quicksand. Now, you might have noticed that we are outside today. We're in my backyard, and it's getting kind of dark out, but that's okay. I'm hoping that we've got enough light that we're going to be able to make this happen, and you're going to be able to see it. So here's what you're going to do, and you might want to do this one outside too, because it is kind of a messy one, just because you're working with sand, and the cornstarch is kind of powdery and fine also. So if you can do this one outside, I would suggest doing that. If not, maybe lay down some newspapers or something on your table and try and be really, really careful so that you're not making a big mess in your kitchen. So what you're going to do, and I think in the materials list, I forgot to mention that you're going to need some kind of container. What I took for a container was this very shallow dish. It's long and it's narrow. A plate might even work well enough, but something with some edges is probably best. Maybe a baking pan. You're not going to ruin it, so you'll just have to wash it when you're done. So you can use whatever container you want. And what you're going to do is you're going to take that container and you are going to add 1 cup of sand. So I've got my bag of sand here and I have my measuring cup. So I'm going to scoop out a cupful of sand. Got my cup full of sand. And I'm going to pour that in the bottom of my container. I'm going to take this big rock out of there because that doesn't really need to be there. So I got my 1 cup of sand. Now I've got my corn starch. And I am also going to get 1 cup of corn starch. So I'm going to measure out. Trying to make as little mess as possible. Again, this kind of flies around. You might be able to see that it's doing that as I'm shaking it out of the box. So there's what my 1 cup of cornstarch, and I'm just going to mix that in. Spread that out on top. And now I'm going to mix those two together. Oops, I got a little on my computer. Be really careful with this. It is kind of messy. So I have it all pretty well mixed. Now I'm going to add maybe 8 drops of food coloring. And I'm going to spread those out as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And I'm going to give that a good mix again. And now you're going to need your water. And the way that you're going to do the water is going to have to be pretty careful. You don't want to add too much at once, because if you add too much at once, it's going to get too liquidy and then it won't do what we want it to do. So I would say get a 1/4 cup measuring cup and add your water 1/4 cup at a time. So I'm just going to pour some of my water from my container into the measuring cup. I've got 1/4 cup of water. I'm going to add that in, and now I'm going to mix. Now when you mix this, you might notice on my fingers it's getting kind of sticky. That's what we want to happen. But it looks like it's still going to be just a little bit too dry. So I'm going to add 1/4 cup of water. Grab my measuring cup, pour my water in. Add my water to the container, mix it up 1 more time. Make sure you work, you're going to have to use your fingers and work kind of hard because it does get a little bit sticky and stiff. So keep working it. You want to get all of that white corn powder or cornstarch mixed completely in so that you can't see any of the white anymore. It looks like it's going to take some more water. So I'm going to do 1/4 cup of water. Another 1/4 cup of water, pour it on there, and then mix it up. You will notice when you're in this, it's going to start to feel different. No longer feeling like sand and cornstarch. It feels something else. Get it all nice and mixed up. Now, I think what I did, and once you have it really well mixed, you'll know because it'll start moving a lot easier. You can see that I can kind of push through here pretty easy. But I think I may have added just a little too much water. So I'm going to add a little tiny bit more, and it's not going to take much, just a tiny bit more cornstarch. We want to get this just to the right consistency. So just a tiny little sprinkle and mix that in. A little bit more. Now we're getting somewhere. Once I did that, now it starts to feel kind of thick again, which is good. That's what I want it to feel like. Maybe even just a little bit more. See how it's starting to kind of resist my movement again? That's what we want it to look like. So I would say when you're doing this, if you do just a little bit more than a half a cup of water, you should be pretty close to the consistency that you want to get. So here's what's going to happen now. I've got this to the consistency that I want. I'm just going to mix in this last little bit of cornstarch. And what's really cool about this stuff is that when you look at it in here, it looks like a liquid, right? But watch what happens if I pick some of it up and I squeeze it. I was able to make it into a solid. Now, as soon as I let go of that solid, though, when I squeeze it, I've got this ball in my hand. Now I take that ball and I let it go, and it becomes a liquid again. So I can keep doing that over and over again. I can make that ball. And then I can squeeze it again. And look what I've made. I've made quicksand. So I could take my little buddy, baby Yoda, and I could set him on top. Oh, little baby Yoda, he's sinking into the quicksand. So there, I made quicksand. So today, what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to make your own quicksand. And after you've made the quicksand, I want you to answer a couple of questions. One of the questions I want you to answer is I want you to answer, what kinds of things could you do to stop something from sinking into the quicksand? Is there a way that you could make that happen? And I'd also like you to, again, try to explain, why do you think this happens? Why do you think this material, when I hold it in my hand and I squeeze it, it feels like a ball, it feels like a solid, but then as soon as I let go, it's back to a liquid? How does that happen? So do your best to try and answer those two questions. Again, I love the pictures and I love the videos, so please sending me those every day. Because it makes me happy to see you guys learning. So have a great day. Have fun making your quicksand. Just make sure you're not making a mess in your mom's house. Okay? All right. Have a good day. I will talk to you soon. Bye.